We're going to look at how we derive an energy balance that allows us to determine how much work it takes to increase the pressure of a liquid from pressure P1 to pressure P2. This means we're going to use the first law, a flow system, steady state, and then notice that this is an adiabatic system, and we're going to do the energy balance for the best case where we can run this isentropic, so completely reversible. So first law says mass flow rate times the enthalpy difference. So let's call this enthalpy H2 and H1 is the shaft work per time. This dot here means mass flow rate per time, and this is enthalpy per mass. And then Q dot. Now, this, of course, is zero because it's adiabatic. Now, what we're going to do is just divide so that we're going to calculate. This is work per time, mass per time. So this is work per mass. So we're going to calculate the work per mass, and we have enthalpies per mass. So first law, we need to be able to get enthalpy values to calculate the work. So how do we get the enthalpy values? So what we want to do is go back and look at differential form of the first law. So let's look at the general form of the first law. And we're going to do this reversibly. dQ is TdS, temperature entropy change. And dW is minus pdV, pressure times the volume change. And now what we're going to do to get enthalpy, we're going to add the PV to both sides of this equation, and then we can simplify. Left side U plus PV, this is the differential of enthalpy. The right side TdS, if we expand this term as PdV plus VdP, right, so this is VdP plus PdV. We can see this term is going to cancel with this term, and we end up with enthalpy as the temperature times the entropy change and volume times the pressure change. Now, we said this is adiabatic and reversible, which means there's no entropy change. And so this term is going to be zero. So now we have the enthalpy change, which is what we want to calculate, as VdP. Well, we can integrate this to get delta H, where delta H, of course, in this system, H2 minus H1. Integral of the right side, well, the volume is constant, right? So here the volume is constant if we consume incompressible liquid. And so delta P, which of course for this system, P2 minus P1. So this enthalpy change is the volume of the liquid per mass, that's important, P2 minus P1. In general, of course, then delta H for a pump for liquid is just the volume per mass times the pressure change. And this delta H, as we saw earlier, is the shaft work that we have to add to the system. This holds, remember, for a liquid. And delta H is not going to be a very big number because V is small, right? So this is volume per mass. So compared to a vapor, the volume per mass for a liquid is small. And so this means that temperature is not going to increase very dramatically. Delta H, Cp, delta T for liquid, temperature is not going to increase very much when we increase the pressure. And it does not take a large amount of work to increase the pressure for a liquid in contrast to a gas.